In January of this year, an Indian group of scientists published a finding that a protein in the Wuhan flu was uncannily similar to that of HIV. It basically wowed people for half a minute, but because it didn't really prove anything about the virus itself, it seems to have been forgotten. However, in this paper they find it startling, since it is basically impossible for the virus to acquire this mutation naturally. It was only in the past week I found out why this is significant. In 2007, a Chinese virology lab published a study in which they were using a coronavirus similar to SARS, which they retrieved from a bat. They found that it does not bind with human enzyme receptors, but after they inserted an HIV protein to this coronavirus, they found it binded well with human receptors. The study was done by the exact same research lab everyone was suspecting before, the Wuhan Institute of Virology, but no one had anything but suspicions. However, according to their own published paper, they literally made this virus. Now, I don't really believe a leak was intentional because, apparently, Chinese people are incapable of being responsible. Still, the Communist Party will not answer for this, even though they knew about it in December and just shut everyone up. The world will forget. Japan won't be punished for using 3,000 people on a cruise ship as a live experiment. The Chinese people will be forced to believe that China's response was the best of all possible responses. And then the cycle will just repeat when the next virus comes from China, like they almost always do. So you can go back to watching your useless crap like mukbang and Mr. Throat now.